This week on the Mr. Throwback Thursday podcast, we bring you Death Sentence Vacated, Snoop's New Shoes, The Possibility of a Refugee's Return, Stars for Your Eyes, Jay-Z Wanting His Money, New Music from MC Light, and a brand new Artist of the Month. What else? Let's listen.
It's not just any day. It's Mr. Throwback Thursday.
All these kids want to get on and shit.
You are now about to witness the strength of street knowledge.
Help me, be dead.
At the count of three, I want y'all to tell me the name of my DJ. 1, 2, 3.
And now, here's your hosts, Bill Winters and Mr. Throwback Thursday himself, Jamie Robinson.
And a pleasant hello to everybody. Welcome to Mr. Throwback Thursday, episode 544. Your two favorite idiots bring you all the hip hop news that you've come to expect as I punch my microphone accidentally. Bill up in New York, Jamie down in Virginia. How you doing, my friend?
I am well. I heard that makes one of us. Yeah, I heard your two times voice in your echo and your two less teeth in your face.
It's funny how that works. Yeah, I had a couple
that adds
of teeth
up to three,
pulled.
Four.
A couple of teeth pulled on Friday. I may look like I've been punched, especially on the right side here.
Yeah. Get your my right side going.
Yeah, a little bit. I'm gonna make one offer you can't refuse. Yeah.
Now, two times dope, meaning a couple of dopes, will accept.
Been called worse.
Yes, we have not been called Acniculus, but we would have to be three times for that.
No, we don't come from Acniculus land.
We do
either.
Not.
You're going to make me say things like that with less teeth in my mouth now? Jerk.
It's what I do here.
No, I had one broken tooth. Again, remnants of the accident years ago with the hockey puck.
Not with the
but
old lady.
Then I had a cyst, I guess, that formed underneath a tooth that I had a root canal done years ago on. And the only way for them to get to that was to take the tooth out and then remove the cyst.
Well, they removed the root and that didn't work.
No. And it didn't hurt. I don't even know. They saw it on an X-ray and they said, yeah, that looks bad. And I said, well, I don't feel anything. And they said, you will.
Yeah.
And I said, okay. So now I feel something because they pulled and yanked and, you know, chiseled and do whatever it is they do when they're taking a friggin' tooth
hot
out.
Tooth spit.
We're going to get into the hot tour girl already.
We are not.
It's nice to be back to our regularly scheduled menu. Although I will say it was very, very cool having Money B join us last week.
It was.
Week,
so. He got up at 7 in the morning just to come out and hang out with us.
His time, yes. So that should give you a cue as to who the artist of the month is this month might. And who should be giving us the record of the week. And everything else that you've come to know and love from Mr. Throwback Thursday.
Yes.
Good morning, Jason. Jason is in the house. We got a lot of crew here. We got 10 people on the stream right now.
What if I were to go like that? What?
Oh, that's a tease.
If you're a patron, you know exactly what that is.
Yeah. So
what it is, what it could be.
And we're still waiting.
Yeah, Money B was really fun to hang out with, Shane. If you go back and check last week's episode.
Yeah, he's a very smart guy.
Oh, yeah.
Educated us to a couple of things. Mm-hmm. He's not just a freak of the industry. He's a student of the industry.
Yes, and he told us a cool story. But if you're not a patron, you don't get to hear that story because that story was redacted.
Yes. Yes, it was redacted as well as any mention of anybody else.
Yep, because so, no one else was there. It's okay.
Names have been changed to protect the innocent
and the guilty. Yes.
And the guilty. Yes. So that being said, we have everything on the plate. Would you please be so kind to hit me with a little of that Triple H and we'll get started.
Sure.
Don't stop.
This is Hip Hop Headlines brought to you by Mr. Throwback Thursday.
Well, get on it. It's your toy.
It is my toy. And I thought with this story when we first reported on it, what was it, a few months ago?
It was, yeah.
About 5 or 6 months ago, maybe. I thought this was going to end up in a fresh in peace.
Yeah.
Thankfully, it has not.
It has not.
W-U-F-T.
Woofed.
Woofed. Which is a PBS and NPR entity, I guess.
Yes.
W-U-F-T. So woofed.org brings us our first article. The nation of Iran has overturned the death sentence to rapper Tumaj Salehi that he received for criticizing the Iranian government.
Right.
And we had talked, as I said, about 5-6 months ago, that a very popular hip hop artist in Iran, Tumaj Salehi, came to fame over his lyrics about death in police custody of Mahsa Amini, was sentenced to death for criticizing the government. Well, the court has assessed his case and found that his past 6 years in prison were excessive since the punishment was more than what was allowed by law. Another branch of the court will now review the case.
So he's been in prison for 6 years, which is excessive, yet they were also going to proceed to put him to death.
Yeah.
So if 6 years in prison is excessive, what the fuck, dude?
Yeah. I mean, sounds like a kill shelter.
Yeah.
You know, if nobody adopts you within. Yep.
If you don't get the call within the 6 years, we got you hanging around here.
His death sentence in April. So it was a few months ago. It was closer than I thought, actually, by a revolutionary court in the central city of Isfahan, created confusion as even Iran's state-run IRNA news agency and the judiciary did not formally confirm it. So such courts in Iran often involve closed door hearings with evidence produced in secretary and give limited rights to those on trial. So sounds like kind of a kangaroo court anyway.
Yeah. Like Cranky said, rules don't matter when you make the rules.
Yeah. It's the golden rule. Mm-hmm. He who has the gold makes the rules.
That's right.
So he had rapped, apparently. He spent a year on charges that supporters said were based on his music and participation in the protests that broke out over the death of Mahsa Amini, who was 22 at the time. She died in the custody of the country's morality police after being detained for wearing her hijab too loosely.
If we had morality police here, we would get arrested for Bill Reed's lyrics.
Everybody would be arrested if we had morality police here. He had rapped about her in a video saying someone's crime was dancing with her hair in the wind. Can't because she didn't have her hijab on.
Right.
He was released and then he was sent to prison again after saying in a video message that he was tortured after his detention in October 22. State media at the time released a video showing him blindfolded and apologizing for his words, which now they're saying is probably made under duress.
Surprise.
Oh, wow. DJ Shane Bond coming in hard with the
PE
with the PE slight tweak or real rock from the rock. United Nations investigators got involved in this. And they said that Iran was responsible for the death and that it violently put down largely peaceful protests in a month-long security crackdown that killed more than 500 people and saw over 22,000 people detained. So apparently fuck the police is not just an American thing.
No, but you're not going to be sentenced to death for it over here.
You won't be legally sentenced to death.
He wasn't legally sentenced over there.
You may receive a death sentence.
Yes,
but it's not going to be adjudicated in a court of law.
It will not be carried out by a court.
Yeah. So, yeah, there's a lot of in that. And I mean, don't get me wrong. I have police in my family.
Yes, you do.
But and I will never understand what they have to go through. But there are a lot of people in that position that have no business being in that position. That's all true. I'll say. Yeah, there are a lot of
we have a very good friend of the show.
Lieutenant Tom,
who was a police officer. Yes.
Mm-hmm. And I'm sure for every one shitty cop, there's 99 great ones.
Yes.
But you don't hear about the great ones because the shitty ones keep doing shitty things.
Well, you don't hear about people who do their job when they're doing their job right.
Well, unless you're reading the New York Post, then they call him hero.
Yeah.
Because anybody who does their job is a hero in the eyes of the New York Post, according to John Mulaney.
Of course.
Hero teacher teaches kids.
Yep.
Well, yeah. So that's a powder keg I'm not ready to light up right now.
No,
I like the title of your next one.
Thank you. I do work really hard on titles sometimes.
Shoes dog dog, who I am still on record as saying I want Snoop Dogg to be like Kenny Albert and provide sports commentary on every sport ever. Snoop partners with Skechers to release limited edition sneakers. Because when I look at Snoop, the first thing I think of is Skechers.
Well, that's what you should think of all the time.
Snoop and Skechers curated a collection. What alliteration.
Yes.
Curated a collection to celebrate the 30th anniversary of his debut studio album, Doggy Style.
Yes.
So what do you have to do? Me. Put them on back first.
Yeah, you just like my doggy style. All right, let me show you real quick. So here's the.
Got to put them on from the back.
Well, it's funny you say that because he's got these high tops here.
Yeah.
Right. But then we're going to go back because I'm all over the place here.
How back?
Way back. He also has the slip-ins. So you got the doggy style slip-ins. And you slip in from the back.
From the back. Yeah. Converse did miss a real opportunity. Yep. Two cultural icons seem to partner with just about any brand or company, no matter how out of the blue it might be. Everybody partners with Shaq.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody partners with Snoop.
Yeah.
Only one of them can cut you. With precision, though.
Yo, that Shaq knife. Let me tell you, I don't think I put it in the news. I did not.
Oh, him and Charles went at it this week.
Well, he released. Which album was it? Can't Stop the Rain, I think. And that had him.
One of the 10 records he's put out, which. Yeah.
But he released Can't Stop the Rain on streaming services now.
Yeah.
And people get to hear him, Nas, and Jay-Z all on the same song.
Which is.
And he's also doing work
impressive.
With a friend of the show, Chip Foo, on his new mm-hmm. release.
Which I can't wait to hear that one when it comes out, too.
But anyway,
gas station the D-O-double-G's latest venture is quite odd considering his hip hop style.
The D-O-double-G is quite odd. Did you see him run the 200?
You know what? For a 50 something year old guy?
Yeah.
He quitted himself pretty well.
He did. I couldn't do it.
I know. They'd have had to cart me off, man. Mm-hmm. He is now joining forces with Skechers for a unique sneaker collection dedicated to the 1993 hit album Doggy Style.
That was pretty good album.
Last week, June 24th, Skechers began selling the exclusive Doggy Style homage collection on their official website. We have a Skechers store by me. I wonder if they have a minute.
Don't know. The $90 and $95. I don't remember which one was which.
The high tops are $95. The low tops are $90.
That would make sense. But I didn't know if, you know, with the slip in from the back option that it was more expensive.
One of a kind shoes feature the unmistakable artwork from the Doggy Style album emblazoned across the upper. The result is a fusion of Snoop's laid back style and Skechers' commitment to comfort. But what really sets these kicks apart is the innovative hands-free slip-on design, eliminating the need for traditional laces. This means you can slip into your new favorite shoes and get moving without missing a beat. Now, I've seen these slip-on shoes. I've not tried them because...
The majority of my shoes are slip-on shoes, whether they were intended to be or not. Well, you know, the ones that I normally wear are 10th anniversary logo ones.
Yeah, those are definitely slip-ons.
Yeah, yeah, those are the ones I wear most of the time.
They're like loafers.
Yes. Boat shoes.
Boat shoes. Especially if you're doing it doggy style.
Yes, that's what he's saying. That's a pro move, no hands.
It is a pro move. Whether you're cruising through the city or just chilling with your homies, the Snoop Dogg with Skechers collab is sure to make you feel like the coolest cat in town. Yeah. He's a dog. Who writes this exactly. shit? Exactly.
I would say it was so easy.
But the shoes are pretty badass looking. Even the bottom. Did you see the soles?
Yes, I did.
Pretty badass looking shoes. They wouldn't look good on me. Sole?
No, they would not. You would have a problem with those.
I could not roll up anywhere in them. But
well, it's like all my Ewings. I don't think they work for you.
No, because Ewings, as dumb as it sounds, Ewings look good on people with big feet.
Yeah.
I don't have big feet.
I wear an 11. I don't have big feet, but
I wear a 9, man. 9.5, depending.
Good morning, next, John. I thought you weren't going to be here.
Article. No gas face for Super 7.
Yes. Just so I can tell you ahead of time, mine will be here tomorrow.
I'm sure they will. Yep, yes.
I got the confirmation. And shop app tells me tomorrow.
Super 7, who has released all sorts of great figures.
Yeah, they just released a Bismarcky Just a Friend one, and it's got him wearing the powdered wig, and the box, or not the box, the card is the shape of a piano.
Nice.
I didn't get that one, though.
Super 7 has now released figures of Def Jam recording artist Third Bass. The two-pack includes articulated 3.75-inch scale figures of the group members Prime Minister Pete Nice
Sinister.
And MC Search.
Friends of the show.
Comes with a walking cane and a wad of cash accessories.
Yes. So Pete gets his cane. Search gets a wad of cash.
It's crazy to see yourself in an action figure. I'm finally cool to my kids, said Pete.
Yeah, Pete's the face on Pete's looks nothing like Pete.
No, not really. But the outfit does look good.
Oh, yeah.
And the rings and everything. Search looks more like him, though.
Yeah, sure. Search got the big sheepskin coat.
Yeah, and the haircut.
Yes.
I mean, that's what makes Search look like Search.
I'm wondering if you take it out, if it's got the Third Bass carved into it.
Ooh. That would be good to look.
Yeah.
Pete should have come with a cigar.
Yeah, in the other hand.
Super 7 has done a great job recognizing many artists from the golden era, and I hope they continue this for many years to come, said Pete Nice.
I may have to get some of those. Remember, I told you the reason I don't have these out, like all my Super 7s, the reaction figures, I don't have any of them out of the box or off the card.
Yeah,
it's not because I'm super collector and they need to stay there. It's because they don't stand up by themselves.
Right.
Because they're like G.I. Joe type.
But
I'm thinking about buying some of those things that you put in their feet so they can stand up, and then just line them all up on my podcast station here.
And Super 7's been releasing figures like this for a long time. Oh, yeah. They've released Run DMC, KRS-One, Eric B and Rakim, Biz, Beasties, Doom, Grandmaster Flash, Salt and Pepper, Biggie, RZA, Kwame, Slick Rick.
Yeah, I have like 5 or 6 Czarface ones.
If you go to super7.com, you can pretty much purchase all of them.
Yeah, they have a hip hop category. You can just click on the link there.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I've got 2 ODBs, like all the Czarface ones, plus the Czarface Ultimate, which is the one in the Booker T pose over here.
Yep.
Couple other ones. Yes, I like Cranky's idea, though. Putting they'll fit in the G.I. Joe vehicles. I might have to get a couple of G.I. Joe vehicles and have Pete and Search rolling around town.
Against Cobra?
Yes, that's who G.I. Joe fought.
Oh, the I forces remember.
Of Cobra.
So, I remember. I don't see Pete and Search joining together to fight anything, right?
I don't know. So about maybe 2 weeks ago,
maybe there's been a little reconciliation. But
I messaged Pete, but he didn't answer me, which is not a surprise. Pete's not a big texter,
and he's a busy guy.
He is. Yeah, have them fight each other. That's So Search posted on his Instagram about 2 weeks ago, a video, and he's talking. He says, "Oh, by the way," he says, "if Third Base were to get back together and tour, what cities would you like to see us come to? I'm asking for a friend." So I don't know if that's him reaching out or if, you know, it's just going to be him and a DJ and, you know, call himself Third Base. I don't know.
Yeah.
It may be absolutely nothing. It may be him saying, all right, well, these people want to see us here. Let me go talk to Pete and Rich and see if we can put something together. I have no idea. It's not a rumor mill. We're not speculating. I'm just saying this is what he said.
Right.
So think about it.
Oh, yeah. I see the Bismarcky one with the piano card.
Yeah.
$20. That's well worth $20.
Yeah. Well, like I said, I got the breaking the TKO crew. I got that in the boombox box. Mm-hmm. You know, Super 7's got a lot of cool stuff. And if for some reason you're not into hip hop and you're just here because you think we're cool, they have everything. They've got all types of music. They've got stuff from movies. They've got skateboard dudes. They got all kinds of stuff.
Yeah, they have a whole music category that has heavy metal and
Ramones in there. I mean,
hip hop, punk, classic rock. I mean, hell, the classic rock is Jimi Hendrix and Bon Scott.
Yeah, they do a really good job over there.
Thin Lizzy, Alice Cooper, a lot of Jimi Hendrix.
Yeah. They had a cool Keith one, but it was before I even knew about them, and it doesn't exist around there anymore. I think it was a Black Elvis.
They have a Johnny Cash.
They do not have a figure of us, Rob.
No. And if we commissioned them to do it, they would go out of business. So
hold on. What's this? Well, okay.
Yeah, like Jeff Dunham's peanut, puppet, yeah. Peanut. All hail the queen.
Yes.
Now, we can only be talking about one person if we say that.
And I hate in this article where they say, was it former hip hop artist or something like that?
She is still a hip hop artist.
Yeah. She may not be active right now doing it. But I don't care what she's done. That's immediately what I think of as her first thing.
But I guarantee if she picked up a mic right now, she would shred.
Yes.
Pretty much anybody else on it.
Yes.
The BET Experience 2024 presented by Walmart officially is here.
That's what I think of when I think hip hop.
The week-long event where culture, music, and entertainment collide is back and bigger than ever. One of the many electrifying performers who will be part of the star-studded lineup this year at the live performances, including the YouTube Theater, the Miracle Theater, the Crypto.com Theater, and the Hollywood Bowl. That's a lot of theaters. In California. Queen Latifah, Dana Owens.
Yes.
Will be performing this year. She began, of course, with the debut album, All Hail the Queen.
I love that album.
Which featured Ladies First. So, five essential tracks from Queen Latifah, according to the BET Experience presented by Walmart.
Yes. Which is better than listening to a top anything list about rap from Forbes.
Yes. So, five tracks that they're saying are essential to listen to, including the aforementioned featuring Moni Love, Ladies First.
Ladies First. Ladies First.
Now, I don't know if we want to play little snippets of this. Everybody knows Ladies First. Yeah, no,
everybody knows. Everybody should know almost all these songs. So.
Yes. Number two on their list, a great track that I think people tend to forget about.
Okay.
Just Another Day.
Just Another Day. Yes.
Because that one's a little more laid back. I mean, you know, Ladies First has that kind of driving beat.
Just another day. Yay.
Weekend Love. Ooh, featuring nice Tony pick. Rebel. Yes. That's a that was a surprise.
Yep.
Good track.
Well, yeah.
But a surprise that they put that on.
Yeah, you give me top five Latifah, I'm gonna probably go all five off of All Hail the Queen, but yeah. that's my personal preference.
How about this one featuring the brand new heavies, Black Hand Side?
Yes.
That was from 94.
Is that on Black Rain?
Yeah, I think so. And again, another soulful song that features jazzy instrumentation, Latifah spitting socially conscious lyrics.
Let me give you
basically a message about racial pride and unity. And that leads to our last song, UNITY,
which was also on the Black Rain album, if I recall.
Yo, who you calling a bitch? That's what I want to know. See, this song was the best because it started off with that nice sax.
Yep.
And then that beat comes in. And then all of a sudden, you calling a bitch? And then she just comes in fire.
Yeah.
Has she been inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame yet?
I don't believe so.
She should be.
Yeah, because Missy was the first.
Yeah,
female hip hop artist.
Female MC.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go out on a limb and say Latifah should have been in before Missy.
I agree,
but
I'm wondering,
and if that's not to disparage Missy.
No. I'm wondering if it's because Missy stayed music and Latifah branched out into other areas, which maybe, according to this article, she is more famous for.
Well, she is well known as an actress now.
Oh, yes.
I mean, she had a jazz record under her regular name.
Yeah.
So when it was I thought Dana, it was a good list, too. They wanted five tracks that you should listen to.
Right.
Which is the kind of list we like, because there were a couple on there that I wasn't expecting.
Yeah. It's not Latifah's greatest songs. It's not my five favorite Latifah songs. It's, I think you should listen to these to get a good feel for who Latifah is.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, that would have been my number one, would have been Wrath of My Madness.
Mm-hmm. But you know what? It's funny. Other than Ladies First, all four, the four other ones all had that more laid back groove to them.
Right.
Wrath of My Madness does not have a laid back groove. Wrath of My Madness will knock two of your teeth out.
Beat was made by Mark the 45 King.
The late great Mark the 45 King. Return of the Refugees.
Yeah, this should have had a question mark after, because this is, it's on page six, so who knows?
There's a lot of variables on this.
I think, okay, when something shows up on page six like this, it's kind of like when I just told you about Search's Instagram video and me making a story out of what I think could happen based on the little thing that I heard him say.
Yeah.
So I don't know, but
I trust TMZ more than I trust page six. Let's put it that way. Ready or not, here they come. Possibly,
yes.
A source tells New York Post page six that the beloved group Fugees are working on a new album. Wyclef previously teased back in November that the reunited group could possibly do something, telling TMZ that anything can happen. Now, they did have a reunion concert.
They did.
And I'm sure Ms. Lauryn Hill showed up 2 hours late to it.
I'm wondering if they're just going to pre-record all of Praz's stuff in case he can't make it to the recordings.
AI is a wonderful thing. It will be the group's first album in decades since they split in 1997.
Yes. Better watch out, John. You can catch a bullet in your bubble goose.
I was just about to say, he's going to get a bullet in his goose. The move comes on the heels of the legendary group announcing they're going on tour as part of Lauryn Hill's extended 25th anniversary of her album, The Miseducation of Lauryn Hill.
Yes.
Also a one and done, as done by Mr. Throwback.
Yes, and not a hip hop album, really, but Okay.
No. The new 21-date tour starts August in Florida and heads to Europe in October.
Do they dance around the border like Cassius Clay during that?
Only if they're defecating on microphones.
Does the tour go through Guantanamo Bay? This is my question.
I don't believe it does, because if they do, that might be where Praz is right now. It might be. The group, made up, of course, of Wyclef Jean, Lauryn Hill, and Praz Michel, were originally supposed to go on tour in 2021 for the anniversary of their album, The Score, because it would have been, what, 25 years at that point, but had to cancel due to coronavirus and the fact that Praz was in jail.
That was later.
They were scheduled to tour last year, but Hill had to cancel dates in November due to vocal strain.
Hmm.
They united on stage last June, about a year ago, at the Roots Picnic in Philadelphia. And then they appeared together at the Global Citizens Festival in Central Park. And November, they played the Kia Forum in Inglewood.
Were they Inglewood,
always up to no good. Hill played a Soho House 20th anniversary event in New York City in September during New York Fashion Week. So they've been out and about doing stuff.
Mm-hmm.
But Wyclef's been busy. He did a surprise set at Mr. Mello in Brooklyn this month after being spotted during the Con Lions at Unique Ernest Culturian After Party series during the Con Festival in France.
Did you just quote?
He travels a lot.
Did you just quote History of the World Part 1? Say, he's a eunuch. He's a eunuch. He's dead.
That would be a good, it's not a fresh flicks, but that'd be a good movie to watch together. I hated the follow-up on Netflix, though.
I couldn't get through it all. I tried. I did give it.
I gave it a chance, and I couldn't do it either.
It was forced, I guess, is the.
Yeah, way too forced.
Yeah, and I never got to see Hitler on Ice.
No, no. And probably a good thing.
Yes.
So if we hear anything on a Fugees album,
yeah,
we'll bring it to you. I'll believe it when I see it. Yeah,
exactly.
Again, with this article, flute your flute, Dre.
I did that just for you.
I know. Hot new hip hop brings us this one. Andre 3000, who I gave you an idea for a football name based off of him. Andre 3000 hitting the road this fall in support of New Blue Sun.
Yes.
As opposed to Black Hole Sun, which was a Soundgarden song.
It was
song.
A Soundgarden song.
Very good Soundgarden song, by the way. Following a series of highly praised intimate performances. Who praised these things?
I have no idea.
At major festival gigs, Andre 3000 set to embark on a comprehensive North American tour this fall, promoting his solo album, New Blue Sun, which dropped last November, to critical acclaim.
Sure,
what critics are acclaiming this record?
The ones who like the titles, because the titles are the songs.
It is not a neon green mankini from Borat, John. I'm sorry to disappoint you.
He wears that one anyway. It's not a special one.
You had to be there for this conversation.
Yeah, but you didn't want to be there for this conversation.
No. Yay, Peggy. anyway, a gas station we passed.
Yes.
Three Stacks is going on tour promoting his Flute to Flute Dre album and playing many different flutes.
Yes.
So
can't have just one.
Yeah. There's no lyrics on any of this. Fully instrumental album highlighting Andre's versatility and creativity as a musician. Unlike his efforts with Outkast, which are rooted in hip hop and funk, this embraces jazz and showcases his skills as an instrumentalist and composer. I think I would rather see Flavor Flav on tour playing instruments.
Well, yeah, because Flav plays so many.
It's crazy. Let's see where the New Blue Sun tour is coming, to see if it's anywhere around either of us.
It's coming to Richmond, Virginia. Which is an hour and a half. I'll
be cheering for Bill or leaving the group if Bill loses before this picture, but he doesn't want to. Trust me, I don't want to take it. So I'm going to be playing very seriously. Richmond, Virginia. If you want to go see Three Stacks. Hour and a half
away. Yep.
November 8th for you.
What I may do. Oh, November 8th is bad. No, it's not. No, it's not. November 10th. I am journeying to Las Vegas.
Ah, so November 8th by you and October 25th by me in Brooklyn.
are you going to stay there if you get there?
I think I'll go back to Brooklyn. Next article. No Diddy remix.
This is kind of amazing.
Yeah.
I'm for it.
I'm for it too, but it scares me.
That they can just, it's his song.
Yeah. Yep. All About the Benjamins. They are doing a remix of it.
Cypher Sounds is doing it.
Cypher Sounds is doing it. Yep. Dookie's been dropped by everybody.
Yes.
Since the video and the stories came out. But now he's been booted off of his own fucking song.
That was the craziest shit.
So Cypher Sounds, the former Hot 97 DJ, has reimagined It's All About the Benjamins and replaced Piss Dookie with the man who murdered everybody.
Look, this is kind of incredible. On
versus Jadakiss.
It's kind of incredible. Let me see if I can get it to come up here, because I know everything in the world muted.
But it's an AI Jadakiss.
Yes, it is. Here. Everybody knows how it starts.
Uh-huh, yeah. Uh-huh, yeah.
It's all about the Benjamins, baby.
For this one,
I mean, it sounds like the original right now.
Yeah. What you wanna do? Wanna be ballers, shot callers, brawlers? Who be dipping in the bands with the spoilers? On the low from the Jake and the Taurus, try to get my hands on some grass like Horace. Yeah, living the raw deal. Three course meal, spaghetti, fettuccine, and bill. But still, everything's real in the field. Yeah, and what you can't have now, leave in your will. But don't not be for trying to bury.
Yes, it is the exact same verse, because it is just an AI version of Jadakiss doing the lyrics. Replacing
Dookie on the song, yeah.
But Cypher has a good reason for doing it. This is the Cypher Sounds No Diddy remix. Because Cypher, this is a huge song, especially in New York. It's a gigantic thing. And if you're not allowed to play
and
Diddy.
And that's what he's saying. He says, where I'm at, Diddy's canceled. Whatever crazy shit happened with him, that's over there. I'm talking about hip hop wise. As a DJ from New York City,
right?
I'm on 94.7 The Block. They telling me I can't play Diddy anymore. I can't play All About the Benjamins. Are you crazy? How am I even supposed to live as a DJ in New York City and I can't even play All About the Benjamins? You need to understand, this is one of the greatest hip hop New York songs ever recorded.
John said it's a cover. It's not. It's a verse has been remixed, redone. Mm-hmm. Everything else is the same. It's just, well, that's the thing. Shane says you got to just play Biggie's verse and keep it moving. You got to be able to get to Biggie's verse on the radio, though.
And do you know why they chose Jada, an AI Jada, to do this? Mm-mm. Jada wrote Diddy's verse on the song.
That's not a surprise.
He says, why can't I then use modern day AI technology? You see where I'm going with this? And put Jada's voice where Dookie's voice was. It ain't weird, because he wrote the fucking rhymes. Mm-hmm. So, interesting. Jada spoke about writing the verse on that in an interview with Talib Kweli's People Party podcast back in 2020. Yeah, that was his man's. When asked by the co-host Jasmine Lee, who penned Puffy's rhymes, Kiss replied, that would be me. It's a funny story, because we was in the MIDI room just rapping and Dookie happened to come in and hear me rhyming. I already had that rhyme and he heard it, was like, nah, that's me. Let me get that rhyme right there. So he took that and put that on the Benjamins. The Lox lyricist almost also admitted that he and Sheik Loach initially didn't like the beat and had to be forced by Diddy to record their verses.
That's in their shiny jacket era. Yeah.
Yep. We didn't really understand what that beat was. It didn't grab us at the time.
But they took the beat from the street and put it on TV.
But Dookie knew that's what makes him who he is. He knew once he got that joint from D-Dot, he knew what it was. That really was like our first commercial and hood hit that catapulted us, besides the mixtape shit that we were doing. Jada also confessed that he hated ghostwriting for Diddy when they were signed to Bad Boy in the late 90s. He goes, I really hate it. After giving Benjamin's Victory Senorita and a couple of remixes, I used to feel like I was taking away too much of me. Didn't know how to morph. It ain't like he was a Nickelback that I knew my whole life and I could describe him how I think he should be. I ain't feel like I could write the bars for myself and give it to him because I didn't feel like it fit it. He had too much money. I was still extra grungy and my mind couldn't think about that much Versace or being on that type of financial level. So it used to conflict with me writing for him. But Duke used to tell me, give me that shit that you would say for you. But I'm like, it ain't going to fit for you. He used to know how to make it work until I got older and realized how easy it was. So, yeah, Dookie doesn't write his own shit. How about
that? Surprise.
Put your star where my eyes can see.
Yes.
Straight star walking in a place to be. Hollywood Walk of Fame gets two new stars, actually.
Ooh, yes. Well, there's probably a ton of them.
More hip hop than the other. But I guarantee if he wanted to, Prince could have been as hip hop as he wanted to be. But Prince and Busta Rhymes are being honored with Hollywood Walk of Fame stars.
Yes.
Organizers revealed the class of 2025 on Monday, June 24th. The Isley Brothers, Jane Fonda, Nia Long, David Beckham, and Green Day among the slew of entertainers in line to receive a star next year, as well as Prince and Busta Rhymes. Busta celebrated on Instagram, writing in all caps because he's very excited.
Yes, as I would be.
As you will continue to hear it from me every single day. The blessings don't stop, so we will never, ever stop. Thank you to everyone involved with choosing me to be blessed with such a prestigious accolade, such as the Hollywood star on the at HWD Walk of Fame.
Yes.
Being in such incredible company for the class of 2025 with such icons as Prince and then he tags everybody else.
Oh, yes.
And then back to.
Did he tag Savion Glover?
He did not. And then back to all caps. Congratulations to all of us. Oh, my God. Some of the other people that he tagged on here. Mm-hmm. The Isley Brothers, Fantasia, Nia Long, Sherry Shepherd.
Sure.
Courtney B. Vance. Glenn Turman.
Of Law and Order Special Victims Unit fame.
Yes.
Wasn't he like the early DA on there?
I think he was. Misty On Point, Green Day, Depeche Mode, Keith Urban, George Strait.
Did he tag Lori Glory? George Strait.
He did not tag Lori Glory. We are the only people who have tagged Lori Glory in anything.
Unless she follows us.
War, the band, you know, because you got to get. Low ride. The B-52s and Adam Carolla.
I believe you said that incorrectly. It's Adam Carolla.
No, fuck Adam Carolla.
I would prefer not to do that. Thank you.
I will say.
Even with Snoop slip-ons or slip-ins.
I will say a lot of these people on this list this year. Celebrating the African-American community. A lot of people on there.
Nice.
The Isleys, Fantasia, Nia Long, Sherry Shepherd, Courtney Vance. So good for them.
Yeah. And one purple guy.
And one purple guy, because, you know, I will have no Prince slander in my.
There is none.
Because he will go shirtless and beat you in basketball, even though he is not alive. So
in his clothes from the kids section at Nordstrom's. Yes. Mm-hmm.
And now, new school news. MIA promotes tinfoil accessories on Alex Jones's show to protect people from, quote, evil dust, end quote.
And that is entirely too much of that shit.
How does he still have a show? I thought they liquidated everything.
Who knows? That's what you take away from this?
Yeah, well, fuck Alex Jones.
Well, yes, but tinfoil clothing line and accessories.
It's MIA. I'm not surprised. This is my shock face.
Yes. It's not your shock G face.
No. My shock G face will put the satin on your panties.
Yes.
We are going to take our first break now because we can't follow up that headline with anything other than taking a few minutes to recompose ourselves.
Yes.
After the break, we will be back with some woo news on Mr. Throwback Thursday, episode 544. You should come back and listen to that.
You should do that.
Yo, what's good? What's good? This is Casanova Rudd from the Golden Era. Yeah, super love to see Casanova Rudd. Yeah, the dude to James, girls have got him locked and all that. Well, right now, you are tuned into my boys, Jamie and Bill, on the home of classic hip hop, Mr. Throwback Thursday. Girls have got him locked, pump it up.
One, two, pump it up. Now, come on, get some. Stop yelling it.
1-2-1-2, what's good, yo? This is Ghostface straight from Staten Island, New York. And right about now, it's time for Woo News with Jamie and Bill. Y'all know what it is. Get it correct. Mr. Throwback Thursdays, Jamie and Bill. You know what I mean? On Woo News. That's what's going down right now. Y'all check this out. Exclusive. Peace.
The RZA. The GZA. Raekwon. Master Killer. Inspector Deck, You God, Method Man, Ghostface Killer, an old dirty bastard.
It's now time for Woo News with Mr. Throwback Thursday.
Jimmy, shimmy, y'all.
Welcome back, Mr. Throwback Thursday, episode 544. It is indeed time for Woo News.
It is.
And Woo News this week has, I believe, three pieces of Woo News.
Woo.
It's like I knew we were going to get off.
It's like I knew we were going to get off topic, and I was going to have to edit a bunch of stuff out, so I was going to have to fill in later on.
Once upon a review in Shaolin.
Yes.
This comes to us from The Guardian.
Because we know that they played. I don't know if they played it in its entirety. They played samples.
30-minute mix.
Okay.
They played
of Once Upon a Time in Shaolin at the art exhibit.
Mona in Tasmania, Australia. Yeah. This waiver that I'm signing, says Cian Kane, the author of the article, says it's binding until the day I die or the year 2103, whichever comes first.
Right.
I'll be 112 years old in 2103, she says, or very likely dead. Who knows if anyone will still be talking about Wu-Tang then?
Right.
Or what state Once Upon a Time in Shaolin will even be in by 2103. This album exists in a sole physical copy, and that's a CD. Will any other than antique dealers even have CD players then?
Mm-hmm.
In any case, I'll make sure not to slip up at age of 111. You can't guarantee that.
Can't
at
111, guarantee,
no. A lot of times you're getting coloring books for Christmas. I must sign, and I'm rigorously frisked, to ensure I have no plans to make a covert recording of what happens next as I enter Tasmania's Museum of Old and New Art. This is where Once Upon a Time in Shaolin will be for the next week as part of the gallery's new exhibition, Name Dropping, examining status, celebrity, scarcity, and notoriety. Once Upon a Time in Shaolin fulfills on all counts, she says. A never-before-released album by a generational-defining group. I didn't think Silver Rings was generation-defining,
no,
but that's neither here nor there.
It's a different generation.
That exists as a single copy in an ornate silver box and sold for millions of dollars. Mm-hmm.
One that we keep getting threats of lawsuits over because we posted a picture of the box that Forbes had posted on their website.
Yeah, that we shared.
Yeah, but I've deleted the blog, so it doesn't exist.
About 9% of the 500 people who get to hear this are traveling from overseas. The gallery closed the waiting list when it reached 5,000 people.
We are overseas, by the way.
For them, we are.
Yes.
When Once Upon a Time in Shaolin was announced in 2015, it came with a unique stipulation. Whoever bought it would not be able to release it for 88 years.
Right.
Or the year 2103. At the time, Wu-Tang's leader RZA called it a big picture statement on how music was undervalued.
Right.
Saying limiting the album to one copy will not immediately reattach value to all recorded music, but the debate that our approach has sparked might eventually lead to a change in the perception, value, and appreciation of music as a work of art. And that is why we feel the sacrifice is worth it. Other Wu-Tang members did not agree.
No.
Clifford Smith Jr., professionally known as
H-O-D, man,
pulled a Randy Orton and just said that it was stupid.
Yeah, because meth makes music for people to hear the music. You know, so I don't know if I've told you before, Kevin Smith was invited to do a documentary on Prince.
Mm-hmm.
At Paisley Park, he was there and recorded.
Second Prince reference of the show.
Yeah. But Prince's manager asked for all the footage. And Kevin's like, well, I got to edit it together. And she said, no, no. This will never be released. It's going in the vault.
Then what was the point of making it?
She said, there are thousands of unreleased Prince songs in the vault. So Prince made music and stuff for himself more than anyone else, it appears. Meth makes music for us to hear it. So that's the difference in. So, but don't you want to hear all the Prince stuff that's in the vault or any of the Prince stuff that's in the vault?
I would love to.
So having,
but I'm not going to go out of my way to
to break into the vault. But that makes that stuff much more valuable because you know it exists, but you can't have it. And you want to at least hear what Prince did that he put away, maybe saving for the future because he thought he was ahead of his time. Maybe he thought, you know, I don't know if I'm quite ready to release this yet. I'll put it there and then I'll play with it later. You don't know.
I would have a different opinion, I think, if Prince was still alive. And it was him saying this?
Well, he did it then. He locked it all up.
Yeah.
And the only reason that I know it exists is because Kevin Smith was talking about it during his.
But I don't trust estates and spokespeople.
Oh, no.
And all that shit because.
But you haven't heard any of it since he's died. No. Have you?
Right. And here's the thing.
He's probably got good people in charge.
I'm not going to go out of my way to alter my day if I don't get to hear it. But if it comes out and it's released, yes, I will listen to it.
Right. And you would appreciate it more knowing that it had been hidden and uncovered, you know, like Al Capone's vault,
you know, which was a big nothing.
Yes, I know. But it adds more value to the work to be appreciated more as art, maybe, you know, not like super duper in a pewter case or whatever the hell this thing is. But I understand the theory behind making it an appreciation, sparking more appreciation for the piece and the work.
I can appreciate that as well.
I would never pay $2 million for it, but you know, I don't have $2 million.
And do you know why you wouldn't? Most art, because they're considering it art, according to this article, ends up in the hands of a rich guy.
Right.
The notorious pharma bro, Martin Shitdick.
Yeah, I heard of that guy.
He paid $2 million for it, of course, at 2016 auction. And this is why, he said. And this is such a Shitdick thing to say. There's a lot of things rich guys do to show off. The press thing is a part of it, but it's also to show your friends or your last company like, hey, fuck you. Look at me. I got this $2 million album.
Right.
Guys do that all the time. That, my friends, is the definition of little dick energy.
Well, yeah. Yeah, but, you know, that's what he did. Now, these, what is it, Paddle 8? Is that? No, that was the auction
Pleaser.
House.
Yeah. Pleaser.
Those guys are treating it more the way it was intended to be treated. You know, they're taking it and this is a work of art and we're going to take a work of art to this museum so it can be seen by others or it can be sampled.
Experienced.
Right. Yep.
So the author says, which brings us to the music. About 30 people are ushered into Mona's recording studio called the Frying Pan. The sound of heavy rain thunders through the speakers. We're offered green tea. A PlayStation 1 sits in the middle of a table, solemnly symbolic. A music industry guy whisper explains that PS1s are considered audiophile grade CD players.
Yes.
We are about to hear a 30-minute mix put together especially for Mona by the Wu-Tang producer Silver Rings.
Yes.
So they played it on a PS1 because it was the best quality CD player they had.
Yeah. It's the best quality CD player out there.
More so than a 2 and a 3 and a 4.
Yeah. Because the PS1, all the games were CD based.
Mm-hmm.
So it had to be super powerful CD player in order to get the whole mass PS1 capabilities out there.
So the employee says, "You ready for this?" as he hits start on the controller. Once Upon a Time in Shaolin is not as thrillingly in your face as Enter the Wu-Tang, no. But it's easily as good as Wu-Tang Forever. It is also far more polished than both and sounds great for it. There are all the hallmarks of the Wu-Tang sound, kung fu films, swords clashing, gunfire, police sirens. But there are also grand string sections, bombastic horns, even an electric organ. It sounds different than any other Wu-Tang album, but also reassuringly familiar, she says. As always, they are self-aggrandizing, filthy, and funny.
Is that aggrandizing?
One lyric that makes me choke on my tea says, "I jerked off the sun like the day was mine."
Yeah.
Okay, then. It is hard to tell how many of the double album's 31 tracks we hear, but two stand out. Inspect the Deck rapping to a completely infectious Morricone beat and an energetic Redman track with a spirited horn section.
So, probably my two favorite MCs that are Wu-Tang affiliated, Deck and Reggie, are the two that stand out.
All the living members to my ear are on the 30-minute mix, which ends with a plaintive chant for the late ODB, "I wish Dirty was here." So as Wu-Tang music goes, it's good. But as a work of art, Once Upon a Time in Shaolin is truly great. For much of the session, most people have their eyes closed, entirely focused on what they are hearing in that moment, which is exactly how I would listen to it, too. It is such a stark contrast to how music is mostly listened to these days. A kind of Muzak for our stressed brains, a means to block out the world around us. Albums have been filleted into singles scattered among playlists. I think of RZA's manifesto, of all the monumental talent that fed into what we were hearing, and I get it. Yes, music does deserve better.
I agree. Music does deserve better.
When the mix finishes, everybody is completely silent. It takes a Mona employee raising his eyebrows for us to remember where we are to applaud while he ceremoniously deposits the CD in a safe flanked by two security guards. As we file out, I speak to a couple of Wu-Tang fans who traveled from mainland Australia just for this. One young guy looks as though he's been belted over the head, visibly buzzing with pleasure. Another man, older, is a little melancholy about it. He says it actually made me feel a bit sad to know we will never hear it again. Well, maybe. Shit Dick, who is now out of prison, live streamed tracks from the album just a few days ago on X, just before the listening party. Pleaser DAO is now suing him, of course, with a Brooklyn judge putting a temporary ban on Shit Dick streaming or disseminating any copies he made of the album. Pleaser have since released a 5-minute sample of the album online as an NFT, which you can buy right now for $1. The Wu-Tang Clan profits from the NFTs, which gives some way to explain why it's allowed. Each purchase brings the album's release date forward by 88 seconds. We talked about that.
Yes.
It would take $28 million to unlock it tomorrow. For the fans, I hope it comes out before I am 112. But the selfish part of me, the part that felt completely transformed by this as a work of art, secretly hopes that we all wait. So there you have it. One person got to listen for 30 minutes, basically talks about it almost like a religious experience.
Yeah. And I imagine it is. If you're already going in as a
with the mindset, fan, yeah,
and an appreciator of art, I imagine this whole big thing is just, you know, making jizz.
Pretty much. Yeah. So, I don't know whether or not I want to spend a dollar to
get a sample,
to get a sample, but, maybe I will.
I don't know.
Again, I really have, it kind of feels like how I feel in the moment.
Yeah.
Next article. See if I can get it right. S H A B B O S.
Yes.
This comes to us from JacksonvilleFreePress.com.
Because why not?
Method Man. Clifford Smith Jr., professionally known as.
Hey,
is the fixer in Bad Shabbos, a 2024 Tribeca Film Festival audience winner. When the Tribeca Film Festival ended on June 16th, the audience had spoken. A zany dark comedy called Bad Shabbos was its audience award narrative winner. And this movie can thank a breakout performance by Clifford Smith Jr., professionally known as
Hey,
for pulling it across the finish line. Now, for those of us who are not of the faith, Shabbos is the day of rest for Jewish culture.
Yes. If you've seen The Big Lebowski, you know.
Seventh day of the week, and it falls on Saturday. Though traditional Shabbat means traditional Shabbat meals generally happen on Friday evening.
Gotcha.
That's the day of the week this family gathers as it welcomes a non-Jewish person into their Upper West Side apartment. Meg is from Wisconsin, and she's joining them because her fiance, Dave, is the eldest son. The meal will also include the introduction of her Gentile parents to the new in-laws. She doesn't know it, but Meg is walking into a hellstorm. Enter Dave's dad, Richard. He's a tad flaky. Dave's mom, Ellen, can't hide her disappointment that her son is marrying outside their culture. Ellen, played by Kira Sedgwick, also known as Mrs. Kevin Bacon.
Yes.
Abby, Dave's sister, is played by Milana Weintraub. And if you don't know who that
Milana
is.
Milana Weintraub, yes.
She is the girl from the AT&T commercials. She's Lily.
Yeah.
Abby is in attendance with her sadistic, unfaithful boyfriend, Benjamin, who is in finance, which is why he's sadistic and unfaithful.
Yes.
That bastard loves needling the baby of the family, the teen boy man, Adam, who can't keep a job to save his life and has mental emotional problems so vast, he masks them with prescription pills. What could go wrong?
And hilarity ensues.
I want to see this now.
Good. I'm glad that we finally have something that is a movie or a show or something that we talk about on here that makes you go, ooh.
So all these crazy people are in here. The filmmakers had a moment of genius. Throw an interloper into the mix. Insert the gatekeeper, doorman Jordan, played by Clifford Smith Jr., professionally known as
Hey,
or better yet, let him insist on interjecting himself into the mayhem as he vies to be the savior, guardian angel, and fixer.
Do it all.
So I really, it says the ensemble of Jewish and Gentile family members is universally well played by the cast, but meth rises from the fray and steals the movie.
I could see that happening.
The casting director could have gone in two other directions. Hire an outrageous, eccentric person like Lil Wayne or Flav, who would make the role even more nonsensical, or book a seasoned comedy actor such as Kevin Hart, Martin Lawrence, who could have milked each comic moment to death.
Right.
Meth was a perfect in-between option. I really want to see this movie now.
Yeah.
So I'm going to have to go on IMDb and find out when the mass releases for this. So
become a fresh flicks. No,
for those of us, for those of you who didn't know that meth could act, apparently this is proof that meth can get it done in front of a camera. Let me get my money.
This was a crazy story to me. I mean, I guess this is how you become a billionaire, but
yeah. Story on Hip Hop DX relayed by Toast Face Grilla. He is recalling the time that Hawaiian Sophie reminded the Wu-Tang Clan that they owed him $500.
Billionaire.
Yo, I want my $2.
Exactly.
Staten Island legend stopped by $1 million worth of game earlier this month and recalled the time Hawaiian Sophie came calling for money that he was owed. About the early days of the Wu, Toast Face was reminiscing, and he began, "One time RZA and GZA were telling me that Hawaiian Sophie was on the list with us to do a show or whatever. We gave him some time. Long story short, Nickelbacks ain't paying the money."
Yeah.
You know how Sophie is. He wait a few years down the line and bring it up to one of the Nickelbacks like, "Yeah, remember that time you ain't really pay me?" Pretty Tony and co-host Gilly the Kid and Wallace Peoples then laughed about the now billionaire never forgetting a debt.
And that, again, that's how you become a billionaire.
Now, see, the fun thing I've always said, and I've heard from other people, and I think it's true. You know, the easiest way to become a millionaire is start as a billionaire.
Yeah.
So, yep. Sophie, to his point, has not gotten to that point yet. U-God.
Ooh, U-God news?
Was on the Once Upon a Time in Shaolin album. Not memorable. Still sucks. No story. Just facts. ODB.
Ooh.
Not on the album, except for a We Miss You Dirty reference at the end. And he is still dead. It is time to review some music, because that is one of my favorite parts of this show every week.
That's most people's favorite part, because we're not talking about it.
Especially when it comes to music that I'm not familiar with. So I really appreciate the one and done's very much.
I don't know
the
one and done this week
is one that I was not familiar with.
I wouldn't expect you to be familiar with this one. I, up until about 3 months ago, I was also not familiar.
It was released in 1989.
A number.
Does not tell me how long it runs.
I've got 48 minutes, 54 seconds.
Sounds about right. My listing on Discogs has 10 tracks on it.
I have 11.
Okay.
We'll figure it
out. This is... I believe, what is this, the second album, first album, One and Done? I don't see another one for
him. I don't see another one. And I'm sure that there are people out there, if they are fans, they will correct us. But I was not able to find another one.
So I'm going to go with a true One and Done.
You should.
There, the name of the record.
You'll get yelled at, not me.
Wow, Dawn of the Magazulu. And it is by Magazulu 2. That's T-O-O.
As in also, yes.
As in also. As if I am a Magazulu as well.
It's like a Dr. Pepper commercial.
Yes.
Don't you want to be Magazulu 2?
Track number one is not an intro. John is going to be very angry. It is called the most played song. Mix It Up. Is it the most played?
Yeah, I'm wondering if that's because people heard it and then went, "I'm done."
Yep.
Let's find out.
Yeah, because nothing on side two is played at all.
No.
These are the forces. This is the power that drives the band.
I expect that guy to be looking for his sister Murgatroyd.
Heavens to Murgatroyd. not often you get a Miami bass combined with a Roger Troutman zap combined with what sounds like a droid from Star Wars.
Yeah.
I'm intrigued. Track number two. We've come to rock. Oh, this is the bassabunga side of the record, by the way. The other side is the cow booma side. Ah. But this just screams Miami.
Oh, yeah. In 1989, a number.
I'm not hearing any lyrics.
You are not.
Track number three, Mixing in the Jungle.
This sounds like, remember Beat Street where Kenny's in his room playing, playing the sounds for Radong Chong, and she's like,
yes,
and he's making the mix for it. Yeah,
it sounds exactly like that. Track number four. Next.
That's what you said when you heard that song.
Next.
Oh, I'm sure that you heard quite a few. Yeah. Off-brand breakbeat groups. next. This song is 50 seconds longer than saying next. So let's next, go to next.
Track number five, Alley Cruiser Boom.
We call this a diss track? We're Dingbat and Airhead.
Yeah. Alley Cruiser Boom.
With Tigra and Bunny.
We like the boom.
I need to know now, is Alley Cruiser Boom a diss track?
Oh, because that was way too coincidental.
What was that, Latrim who did?
Yes. Track number six, or B1 if you have the record. Mix It, Baby.
Miami, what's up? Matt's gonna rock those guts.
Concentrate on the music.
It's what we say. This came out in 89. This says 90 up here, but it came out in 89. And I bet you Latrem was probably like 88. So that could be.
That's got to be a diss record. That's got to be a diss record.
Dingbat and Airhead. And we like the. Yeah.
Wow. Track number seven, or B2, I believe is the title track.
It is.
Dawn of the Magozulu.
Upon a time in the days of the Rap 2C,
the rep Tusi.
Commercial and cosmic proportions echoed out among the inhabitants.
Can you
of the
dance the rap Tusi?
Ah,
do the rap Tusi. 3000 needs some flute.
Replace the Casio keyboard with some three stacks.
Flute drag. Track number 8, or B3, if yes. you will. Urban Fantasy.
Jerk your face. That delivery is very much mother. There is no other like mother. So treat her right. Treat her right.
I was trying to put my finger on what it was. And you have nailed it. That's what it was.
Mother. So treat her right. Treat her right.
God. I played that for Janelle on Mother's Day, and she just looked at me. She's like, what in the fuck is wrong with you?
You're an idiot. Yes, I know.
Track number 9, or B4.
Yes.
And after. For the love of you.
Is that a frog? Burn it.
Wishing star, open my eyes, and there you are, the living picture of my dreams. Looking for love, it's you I see, but you seem so far away. What can I do? I want you here right next to me. Oh, pretty baby, can't you see?
The love of you is not a thing I want to do. Spend my money.
So it's the Magazulu slow jam.
Track number 10, Harvest for the World.
I don't know what's going on with this.
Everyone are Apple Bus are satisfied. Apple Bus in.
That's Spotify saying you did not mean to play
seriously,
this record.
Maybe that's why the second maybe it's why the second half of the album doesn't get played, because it just does that.
Maybe. And now you said you have an extra track after that.
It is a 6-minute and 19-second song called Jazz It Up.
See, I don't have that anywhere. So
maybe you should be
jazz
happy.
It up.
Please make that stop.
You didn't want to jazz it up anymore?
No, I was all jazzed out at that point.
Magazulu 2 with Dawn of the Magazulu.
Wow,
you're one and done for episode 544.
The one and please
you
be
know
done.
What? As terrible as that was.
Look, we've discovered
a new diss track.
It was
somewhat strangely, oddly entertaining.
Yeah, we have discovered a diss track that we did not know existed.
That is the saving grace for this
it
record.
Is. You got to find it somewhere. That was horrible.
Hey, did you ever hear La Trim? No. Did you ever hear anybody who hated La Trim so much that they wanted to diss him? No.
Somebody else from Florida?
You want to hear it? Here it goes.
Oh my God. That was horrible.
Yeah, so Magazulu 2 with Dawn of the Magazulu. I have no singles what? Released off of this. I have no charting action on this.
All right, look, Shane Bond said that was bad, and he's from Florida.
Well, he would know. So
God.
It wasn't great, but
no,
it was delightfully bad. Yeah, it was delightfully bad.
Yes, it was an entertaining bad album.
We give people that moment sometimes.
We do.
Let's see if we can't make it better.
You're blurry. Stop being blurry.
You're blurry. I'm blurry because of that album.
Yeah, that's fair.
How's that?
That is better.
That is better.
I mean, I can see you better. I don't know if it is better or not.
No, probably not. Let's wash the taste of Magazulu out of our mouth.
If that is a thing that we can do.
Give it a little gargle rinse and a hot two yes. Spit on that thing. Had to get that in there.
I would prefer the banana split at this point.
There's a drink called that.
By the way.
Yeah, the Hock 2 banana split. I'll have to send it to you. It's hysterical. Record of the week.
Yes.
Coming to you by your new artist of the month for July of 2024. Because believe it or not, we are more than halfway through this fucking year already.
Yeah. I was writing the show and I got down. I was completely done writing the show and I went, wait a minute, what's today's date?
Which, by the way, today's date as we're releasing. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear America. Yep. To paraphrase Gunnery Sergeant Hartman.
Yes.
Happy 4th of July to everybody. As yeah. That is the throwback Thursday that this is being released on.
And you and everybody's out there banging that Magazulu 2 at the cookout.
Yes.
Jesus.
They should be banging this one, though. The record of the week comes to you from your new artist of the month, which if you were listening last week, you probably have a very good idea. Your artist of the month is Digital Underground.
It is.
Digital Underground, an alternative hip hop group from Oakland, California.
I love that they're an alternative hip hop group. That wasn't even a thing when they came out.
Gregory Jacobs, who was Shock G and Humpty Hump.
Mm-hmm.
And MC Blowfish.
Yes.
As well as Money B.
Mm-hmm.
And who else were members of this group? Shock G, Kenny K, Chopmaster J, DJ Fuse, Money B. Tupac was actually considered a member of the group for a bit. So
almost the back row, two seats.
Whole lot of people at one point, and now consisting like with Young Hump. And so
every audio is in the
album that we are doing
$69 a seat
is.
I would consider going
the fifth album in the catalog of Digital Underground. No. It was released September 8th, 1998.
For the show.
Running 52 minutes and 44 seconds long, produced by the D-Flow production squad and released on Jake Records.
Yes, because all of our Jake Records were hits.
The name of this record is Who Got the Gravy?
And you know, all I can think of is this time I didn't forget the gravy. The
gravy. I have 11 tracks on this.
As do I.
And Shane Bond, rest in peace to Kenny K. If he was like your big brother, I am sorry for your loss.
Yes, yes.
John Henderson will be happy.
Yes.
Track number one, I Shall Return, subtitled Intro, featuring KRS-One.
Yes.
Yo, you know what's up. Turn this up right now. Ha, ha, ha. Like that, y'all. You don't stop. It's the digital. It's the KRS-One with the digital. Yo, you know what's up with that. We about to set it on you. Ha, 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 ha.
So, like, featuring KRS, is that like... Channel Live that featured KRS or Steady B's mm-hmm. remix that featured KRS. Come maybe. Again, Steady B like this.
Track number two, Holla Holiday.
Yes, yes.
Follow that music and listen for the rhythm.
Yeah.
weighs a ton.
Track number three, featuring Essence Chill.
I'll go with that.
Morning, called Captain. Wind Me Up.
Wind Me Up.
Welcome to the Blue Diamond, y'all, ladies and gentlemen. I'll be your host, Edward Ellington, Humpty Hump, Humphreys III, and we're going to get it started up here.
Now we know Humpty's full name.
Yes, Edward Ellington, Humpty Hump III.
Rupert Gibson, Brianna.
Edward Ellington, Humphreys.
Big Mama Dottie Mac Taylor.
Track number four featuring Big Pun, Bust Stop, and Whatever. It's called The Mission.
This is Red Dog One, come back.
This is Black Sheep, copy.
State your position.
Well, I'm in zone three, but it's looking pretty dry out here. Request permission to put the mission in action.
Affirmative, Black Sheep 5, that's a green light. You can set it when you're ready.
10-4, Red Dog, it's on.
Yo, question. What does an Afro rockin' X dropping West Side type have in common with an East rocker vest? Put you to rest high.
What?
Women, we swimming in them like batter. I'm bony, he fatter.
Watch,
my bad pun, I'm having fun playing with my kid's side. I'm ready to hit the telly, tickle belly.
DJ Shane Bond giving us all the history.
Yeah.
Yes, Greg met Kenny K, DJ Kenneth Waters, and Jimmy Dreit, known as Chopmaster
J,
of Berkeley, California, back in Tampa in 1987, and formed Digital Underground. See? We learned something.
Yeah.
Track number five, featuring Biz Markie. Second Biz reference of the day. Odd Couple. Any couple with Biz is an odd couple.
Good googly good. Look what the cat dragged in, the Max back in. We snap crack in, we got the jokes for you. Look who the hump bumped into, the 012. Rhyme slayer, the paper maker, Biz lay the vapors.
I'm the vapor sprayer from the Himalaya. The M is the A, R is the K, I'm the mayor. Leaving MCs in the ditch.
So get ready, we about to start a fire in this bitch.
Humpty Dumpty had a fight with his mom. She broke both her legs and both of her arms. Tidy bold man tried to throw a fit. I told his punk ass he was full of shit.
Bringing out the tidy bold man.
God, I miss Biz. What a great collaboration that is right there. Track number six, Blind Mice.
Watch this.
Patty cake, patty cake, I heard your man wears a gold Rolex and put a diamond on your hand.
The itsy bitsy spider was a hoorah. Said he met the judge's daughter.
There's our man Money B. Track number seven featuring Truck Turner, The Gravy. Kind of, I guess, the title track.
I guess.
Do you?
Only if he tells us who has
Truck
it.
Truck Turner. Why? Yeah.
But Humpty Hump about to put his thing bang down. PDP in the house. What's up? What? Truck T in the house. Yeah. Here we go again. The paper to the pen. Yet to bring the lion's den. I've already begun. Skypock on my tongue. Bottles up love. Daddy's about to come. And cough up the lyrical loogie.
Cough up the lyrical loogie.
Well, you can't leave it there. I was going to say, what do you do with that after you cough it up?
Hock you got to spit.
Spit on that thing. Track number eight. Peanut Hakeem.
which is a Shock G.
We gonna show that there's been a rush to judgment regarding the respectability of my client. Okay.
Anybody got change for a 20?
Objection, Your Honor. He's soliciting my client. I mean, he's purposely trying to pro fornicate the matter concerning my boo here. I mean,
shake it up.
Objection. He's leading the witness.
So remember we told you last week that on Wednesday, Money B was going to host that Web3, the chat in the Gala Music platform. And he told us how he was going to show everybody around his studio and whatnot.
Yes.
So I was there for that. And I got to ask him questions in that chat that I didn't get to ask him on the show because we were trying to steer toward his new stuff on the show.
Right.
One of the questions I asked him was who had more alter egos in his opinion, Shock or Cool Keith? And he said Shock and Cool Keith were friends. And he wondered if they kept creating alters to see who could outdo the other one. He said, because, you know, everybody knows that Shock had Humpty and MC Blowfish. And he's like, no, but he had Peanut Hakeem. And he went down all this list of Shock's alters that we didn't know about. And I was like, man, I knew that he had more, but I didn't know that it was anywhere near the level of Keith or that they were friends. But that makes total sense to me.
I didn't know he had that many either. I knew about the ones on the records, but
we were trying to push his new stuff. So I didn't want to linger on old stuff during the show,
as we were strongly directed to do.
Well, yeah.
So which makes sense.
I jumped into his chat and asked questions.
Track number 9, Man's Girl. Is that your man's girl?
Anybody got change for 20? Shake it up.
Track number 10 featuring Mystic, April Showers.
I heard they bring May flowers.
And do you know what May flowers bring?
New bugs.
Pilgrims.
Horrible.
Sensuality, embrace your reality. Moonstones drip, slip out about a sea. Continuously, we be getting freaky.
Is that Ladybug Mecca?
It kind of had a sound like that. Track number 11, last track on the record, featuring once again KRS-One.
So when you have multiple, when you have multiple saber-tooth tigers, would they also be saber-teeth tigers?
But if they're computerized, they are cyber teeth tigers.
Yes.
Oh. Yeah. Hey, yo, Chris, tell them what's up, yo.
Yo. 1, 2. Coming at you live and direct.
That's right.
Digital Underground King. You know what's up.
Hey, yo, Chris is chilling. Shot G's chilling. What more can we say about the villains? The real killers chilling in the white, I mean the not right house. Want me to be they lab white mouse. The smiling CD greedies, the pride and the needies, breaking treaties. Overseas wildin' while they profiling them.
That is your record of the week for episode 544 from your artist of the month for July of 2024. Digital Underground with Who Got the Gravy. This time we didn't forget the gravy. I have Do we have any singles released off of this?
That I don't know. If
I do not see any singles released off of this. The album did not reach the Billboard 200, but it did hit one chart, the top R&B hip hop albums, where it peaked at number 91. It's not one of the more well-known Digital Underground albums.
That's kind of why I played it, because, you know, we've done Sex Packets, of course. Mm-hmm. You know, I don't know if we've done Sons of the P or
I thought we did Sons of the P first.
We may have. But, you know, the further along Underground got, the Lester stuff was played. And I'm not saying by the people who listen. But when you get away from Humpty and get more, Shock was obviously an experimental artist.
Absolutely.
So in the later 90s, when you have artists like Wu-Tang, you had Terror Squad, you had DMX was prominent. When you get into that time period, the eclectic artistic view is not what is being pushed. You know, you took Humpty out of the equation. He's not the featured guy because we're into a harder, I don't know. The lane changed and they were still in their lane. So the people who listened to them were still going to listen. But if you were not an underground fan, you may not have known that they released these other later albums.
Because they have how many of them altogether?
They've got a lot of albums.
Let's see. Let's take a look at their chronological since they're artists of the month,
we can do that.
Yes. We have their discography consists of Sex Packets, mm-hmm. Sons of the P.
Yep.
The Body Hat Syndrome,
right?
Future Rhythm.
Mm-hmm.
Who Got the Gravy?
Yes.
And then 10 years later, because the DU party don't stop.
Yes.
And then this is an EP release, a.k.a. same song.
Mm-hmm.
And the Greenlight EP. They also appeared on soundtracks of Nothing But Trouble.
Yep.
Don't Be a Menace to South Central While Drinking Your Juice in the Hood.
Yeah.
And Tupac Resurrection. They were also on some compilations. Yo Rap Hits, Oakland Soul, the Bay Area soundtrack, No Nose Job, The Legend of Digital Underground.
No Nose Job. Yeah.
The Lost Files, Outrageous Rap.
I almost had
Play
you do
What You Like, no, The Best of no Digital Underground. Rhino High Five, Digital Underground. Songs You Know, Old School Hip Hop, and West Side Bug presents The Best of the West. So, nothing was released off of that record as a single. I'm looking at the singles they've all released. Yeah. And no, unfortunately, nope. Sex Packets had like five of them.
Yeah. Well, that's because
six.
See, during that time,
mm-hmm.
that was a whole different vibe. I mean,
you know what their first single they ever released was?
No, because the first one I remember was Do What You Like. And I know that probably wasn't their first
year before that. Underwater Rhymes. And then Do What You Like, and then Humpty,
mm-hmm.
and then the Do What You Like remix with Packet Man.
It's your Packet Man.
And then Freaks of the Industry as a U.S. promo only.
Which there was no video for, as we found out last week.
Right. And then same song, and then Kiss Me and I'll Kiss You Back.
La, 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 la.
Yeah. As well as No Nose Job, which came off of Sons of the P.
Yeah. No Nose Job.
The Return of the Crazy One and What's Up with the Love off of Body Hat Syndrome. Oregano Flow and Walk Real Cool off of Future Rhythm. You know what? They did release two singles in 98 off of Who Got the Gravy, but they didn't chart anywhere.
Good day.
U.S. promos only of Wind Me Up and The Mission.
Gotcha.
So there you have it. Everything you needed to know about your artist of the month and your record of the week,
yes.
which was by your artist of the month for it's episode 544 Digital Underground, bringing you Who Got the Gravy. We'll remind you that your record of the week was, or your one and done was Magazulu 2 with Dawn of the Magazulu. And before we take our final break of the day, we have an old to the new.
We do.
Not the Magazulu new, just old to the new new.
Old to the new too, as well, like Magazulu.
And ironically enough, the name of the song is King King, but it features two queens of the industry.
Indeed.
MC Light featuring Queen Latifah with King King. You're old to the new for episode 544. Give this a listen right now.
Yeah. Yeah, this is dedicated to all the kings, and all the soon to be kings. We're counting on you. We love you. This is for you, you and you and you. A mighty king. He's a king, king. Go ahead and king him now. Yeah, you got it. I see you here doing your thing, king. You love that girl, bought her a ring, king. Love's never just a rinky-dink thing. Proud of you, got the bling-bling for the queen. Fam's happy and they just wanna sing, sing. You ready to spin your whole ching-ching. Your whole check, nothing less to be given. Years later, you've risen to elevate your position. You a groom now, and your homies can't believe it. You was out there, feverish, your love allegiance. But you always left your heart open for the teaching. Learn about what it takes to make it through the seasons. Make the best choices for your fam, man. So excited that you took a hand, man. And waited for love to do its thing, king. You got the woman of your dreams on your team. Let's go, king.
It's your crown. Hold it, even if it all falls down. Show it. You know the world is watching now. I know you get tired from keeping it all together. We need you. It's your crown. Hold it, even if it all falls down. Show it. You know the world is watching now. I know you get tired from keeping it all together. Yeah. We need
I
you.
I hear if you hear it enough. Believe it, king be it, king live it, king receive it, straighten up your crown, king. Let nobody knock you off your square, and the joy that you bring, let your light shine bright, illuminate the night. People looking in may assume that you might get caught in beauty and hype, because a cutie's your type. It's cool to be choosy about your soon-to-be wife, so never let them hating spectators underrate you, and tell you that your nature is less than stellar. Tell them good God made you, and you made you. You were made to create by the creator. And loving on your woman is something to be proud of. When you tell her that you love her, say it louder. King Vision, no Oprah, no small frame can hold ya. Made to be king, God soldier.
It's your crown, hold it. Even though it all falls down, show it. You know the world is watching now. I know you get tired from keeping it all together. But we need you. It's your crown, hold it. Even though it all falls down, show it. You know the world is watching now. I know you get tired from keeping it all together. But yeah, we need you.
Yeah. You's a mighty, mighty king, king. Come on, forget the fling, king. I see you, you gave a ring, king. Congratulations, my king, king.
It's your crown, hold it. Even though it all falls down, show it. You know the world is watching now. I know you get tired from keeping it all together. But we need you. It's your crown.
I would most definitely peep that record many times.
Yes.
Queen Latifah featured with MC Light on King
as
King. You're old to the new for episode 544. We're going to take our final break of the day. We'll just remind you, your artist of the month, Digital Underground, with your record of the week, Who Got the Gravy? And your one and done was Magazulu 2 with Dawn of the Magazulu. After the break, Bill reads lyrics on episode 544 of Mr. Throwback Thursday.
And now, directly from the planet of Brooklyn, MC Light.
as a rock.
1-2-1-2, mic check. Check it out. This is MC Light, and you're listening to my boys, Jamie and Bill, on Mr. Throwback Thursday.
Guys, watch, even some of the girls rock. Step back, it ain't that type of party. No reply if you ain't somebody. Get out my face, don't want to hear no more. If you hate rejection,
don't get hip hop.
But it starts with Bill.
I'm Bill S. Preston.
It's called reading. Top to bottom, left to right. Group words together as a sentence. Take Tylenol for any headaches. Might offer any cramps.
Most people probably don't listen to the lyrics, but they should.
Welcome to Bill Reads Lyrics.
Hello, this is Bill Reads Lyrics. It is an educational discussion of artistic expression and creativity of modern lyricists. Bill may recite explicit or offensive language. Professional supervision is suggested for sensitive listeners. The average views and opinions within these lyrics are not necessarily those of Mr. Throwback Thursday or its hosts, and will be in the area of 160 WPMs. We hope that you will find our presentation precise, humor-heavy, and just right. Thanks.
Thanks.
Welcome back, Mr. Throwback Thursday, episode 544. As I unmute my microphone so I don't talk over the disclaimer, it is indeed time for Bill Reads Lyrics.
Yeah.
And
XL <I'm>, edition.
Yeah, that's kind of what I've been understood.
So I'm just gonna come over here to the chat and send it to you, and then we will figure the rest out from there.
Sounds good.
No, it doesn't. It'll sound disturbing as you go along. Don't worry.
It's always disturbing.
So just find the word spiral.
As in staircase?
Yes, you would think.
Okay, so that's the intro. Okay, I found it.
So we're going to start there, and you're just going to read everything until it says outro. You can stop there.
Okay.
So with no type of ado and probably not enough piano.
Play it twice.
Whether nearer or further. We will cue that motherfucking piano.
Spiral dunk with Erica. Take a dump. Your man on a skateboard gon' think my shit is German funk. Watch your baddest bitch shit a big chunk. Leave a white stripe on the ass like a black skunk. The kids call him Drunk Unk. They vocals and music sound pussy like a pump. Regional doo-doo. You constipated with a Tampax between your boo-boo. None of you can fuck with the pressure of leakage in your drawers. Got you searching for bathrooms on tours. Fuck what you did earlier. What the fuck you doing now? My lyrics stain all over you. You see the spots on the cow? Grade A meat. If you got a tiger to come get it, I'll put a tough steak out on the street. Melt that shit around your face, down with factory heat. Backpack your shit up, then back out. You can't compete. The Phantom got him looking like a bitch behind the curtains, feeling elite. Caffeined up. These guys, they T-sweet Cherokee looking for Bigfoot. Y'all scared to get out. Your woman took a shit in the Jeep. That's what she get for trying to sit in the hot seat. Never respected a bitch sleeping with a Nickelback that smell like corn cheese feet. Nasty motherfucker. Girls don't like me because I use a rubber. Fuck you, asshole. I'm not that don't take a bath, brother. Keep the underarms with deodorant under. Watch them black ass tights under them jeans. That like a sundress. Watch you smell like fish and shit this summer. Back up in the parking lot with Barney face on the hood. The green trim on the purple Hummer. Xbox built in the dash. Women break out mad. I put a condom on to fuck my cash. Built up all my public announcement shit. My style is a movie flick. Like me filming lactose out your tit. Abuse your confidence till you quit. Put some salve on that canker sore on your lip. Go on your computer and grab a washcloth for your foggy forehead. Grab that natural organic, then wipe it off. I can tell you're a bitch with drawers, with a plaid tablecloth. A chipmunk with cat manure in his drawers. Salmonella sweating through his pores. Red carpet dickheads better respect my laws. Don't get shit of mine's twisted with yours. But get his piss in the dude's face like George Simple Simon. Catch. Your bitch wanna have an org, but you think you're better than the Bible. You're a fucking lord.
Yay.
I don't give a hoot about this Bill reading lyrics bollocks. Let's get back to the hip and the hop, shall we?
There's a lot of dudes.
I
going
read
on
it
there.
And I'm not sure what I read.
I don't know what that where you find a chipmunk like that.
With cat shit in his paws? I don't know.
No. Yeah, no, there was so much stuff. I actually think way back in the day, we did part of this song because I remember corn cheese feet. And it may have actually been an episode title. I remember
I might have read those lyrics before, maybe not all of them.
No, you definitely did not read all of them. That was probably, you know, like a 8 lines that you read or something.
Wow. Corn cheese feet. Well, there you have it. That's Bill Reed's lyrics for you for episode 544 and your corn cheese feet. And your lactating tit.
And all the other crazy shit.
And the hat has been switched.
All right. Well, then you, sir, should proceed to take us home.
By all means. Episode 544 of Mr. Throwback Thursday brought to you in part by Magic Mind, your secret to a sharper mind. And Calm Energy. Use our limited offer that gets you up to 48% off your first subscription or 20% off one-time purchases with code THROWBACK20 at checkout. You can claim it at magicmind.com/THROWBACK20.
Yes.
The world's strongest coffee, Death Wish Coffee, goes great with your Magic Mind in the morning.
It does.
Go find them on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, or at deathwishcoffee.com. Use the code TBT to save 12% off your initial order. And then the code THROWBACK will save you 10% off of every following order.
Yes.
At deathwishcoffee.com. The world's strongest coffee, deathwishcoffee.com. Def Rugs, defrugs.com. Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, all at Def Rugs. Handmade, high quality hip hop theme rugs brought to you by the original Ruggy Fresh himself, Marshall Fox, and his business associate, the green eyed bandit, Eric Sermon. Get yourself a Def Rug by going to defrugs.com. Our friend Heather Lent up in Schenectady, New York, is the proprietor of the Bittersweet Candy Company, where she makes candy and chocolate that is handmade, small batch, different and
delicious.
Check them out on Facebook and order at bittersweetcandy.com. Use our code throwback and save 10% off your order at bittersweetcandy.com. Melted Mics, MLTDMICS, MeltedMics.com. Mm-hmm. Our code MR Throwback Thursday. Save you 10% off of hip hop themed t-shirts brought to you by the wizard Pumice T. Mandola.
Yes.
Who comes up with some great t-shirts, which is one of which is now your avatar picture on your Facebook page. Bother nobody.
I came up with it. He just has the execution.
Mm-hmm. And don't nobody bother the mayor.
That's so, right. Oh, did I show you this one?
Universal Hip Hop Museum, New York, which is now just the Hip Hop Museum.
Right. So the sleeve is right.
Yes.
But the front,
they changed
is not.
The U to a T, didn't they?
Yes.
Now it's just THHM yep. on there. Very cool. So go check out MeltedMics.com. Last but not least, Etsy.com/shop/geeklikeyou, where the geek shall inherit the earth, hip hop and pop culture items from the sick, twisted mind of Mr. Throwback Thursday and his sick, twisted wife, Mrs. Throwback Thursday. Yes. Go to Etsy.com/shop/geeklikeyou, where the geek shall inherit the earth. Social media network. Don't forget to visit us, MrThrowbackThursday.com. Leave us a voice message by clicking that little microphone that says hit us up. Mm-hmm. Or you can follow us on our other socials at Twitter. @_MR_TBT and Bill_MR_TBT, which is also my Instagram and Threads page. Jamie on Instagram and Threads is MR Throwback Thursday, which is also the page you can find our TikTok on, where we put snippets that won't get us canceled.
Hopefully.
Good snippet of Money B last week on the
tickety-tockety. Thank you. I thought it was a pretty good one.
I thought it was very good. And you can also go to Facebook and follow Mr. Throwback Thursday, now that that's back up and running.
Yes.
As well as the Mr. Throwback Thursday podcast and Home of the TBT Posse. Yes, so
we will monitor all that stuff.
Yes, we will. It is shout outs time.
Yes.
Shout outs this week go to Gail Dunmire. And by the way, happy birthday to Brian Dunmire.
Ah.
It's his birthday today. Manny Baez, Sarah Henderson, John Henderson, Hugo Gonzalez, Sanket Patel, Teresa Lynn Simple Luxuries at TeresaLynns.com, Clay Arsenault, the Shrieking Warrior Jennifer Buchanan, Jason Heath, Jessica Walker, Shane Hatley, Ricky Schnarr, ahoy matey.
Yes, yes.
Kenneth Elsfelder, Mr. Cranky Pants Brian Hollenbeck, the legendary Kevin Van Buren, Rob Jeffroy, Kate Harvey, Catherine Liska, and Wanda Calamia. They get mentioned every week because I got five
on it. Or more.
You want to get your name mentioned every week? Become a patron. Go to patreon.com/MRTBT or MrThrowbackThursday.com. There's a little tiny link on there that says become a patron. It'll bring yes. you right there.
And there's a new thing with Patreon. You can now pay for a year in advance, so you don't have to have it taken out every month if you would like.
Oh, excellent. Don't forget our friends in the industry, as always. Check out the 1980s Now with Will, Kat, and John. Check out Anthony, Imran, and the Rug Boy over at the Jock and Nerd podcast. Check out our friend Talking Ty on her show, What's the Word podcast, mm-hmm. or Brooklyn Ty NYC. And check out the hardest working turntablist in the world, DJB. He is on itsfreshradio.com and the Fresh Radio app for your phones. We are on there every Thursday morning at 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on Fresh Radio, right after the All Request Show.
Yes.
If you want to get in on the All Request Show, you tweet your requests to be at Real Fresh Radio, and he will get them in and yes. stick around and listen to our ridiculousness.
Yes.
We're also on Wild One Radio at Wild One. That's the numeral one.
Yes.
Wild numeral one radio.com. We're on at 7 a.m. Eastern Standard Time and all throughout the weekend. Go check out wildoneradio.com. Four times. Don't forget to subscribe, rate, review, and all of that good stuff. Go find us, share Please. The good word, take good care of yourselves, take good care of your teeth, wash your hands,
wash your butt.
And until next time, keep it classic.
And like Cool Keith said, Jello to jelly, they live in our belly. Ladies with thongs moving booties in the hotelly.
And always remember,
new school stale, old school fresh.